Well, it was 20 years ago that a series about a ruthless North Jersey mob living in suburbia, and the boss was with his wife and two teenage kids. It premiered 20 years ago on our screens. Then for the next 8 years, we followed the lives and some really grisly deaths of the Sopranos cast. Now, three of the biggest stars are in Australia for the very first time for a special Q&A session. Please welcome Stephen Schirripa, also known as Barbie, and Vincent Pastore, known as Barbie and Kelly. Also, Big Pussy. Hello, Big Pussy. And also, Michael Imperioli, who is known as Christopher. Gentlemen, this is a magic moment for me. I have just been an adoring fan of the series from where to go.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Happy just to be here.
Sensational. The characters, let's face it, it was hardcore grisly deaths and murder and mayhem. In that reality of the show, which you did so convincingly, did any of the real Mafia boys ever knock on your door or be proud of what you were doing?
Yeah, they knock on my door once in a while.
Well, you know, over the years, of course, you know, they start thinking you're the character. I'm sure you get the same thing in the soap. And, I lived in Manhattan and, I was bringing my laundry to the cleaners. And the guy said, hey, I love the show, but, you know, last night, anyone who's ever killed anyone knows that's not how you do it. And I went, all right, I got to get going. I'll see you soon, God. You know. Michael's had some...
I've met a few people. Yeah, people...
They're around.
For the most part, liked the show, which was good. I'm glad about that. I'm glad they didn't like it. Yeah. That would have been bad.
Well, the first season, they loved my character. The second season, because I played a rat, they didn't want to talk to me.
Seriously?
Now, yeah, I swear.
Are you Vincent? I'm trying to get the names right. Vincent. Yeah, I know the show is a global hit, even though it was set in New Jersey. But you were on a billboard in Times Square, right?
Yeah.
All of you guys.
The first season, that's what HBO did. They put us on Times Square. It was kind of mind-blowing.
So, how was that?
That was right. Yeah, that was... I think that's a big moment in somebody's career.
Oh, definitely. Yeah. Did you go by and put clothes beneath the building?
Absolutely. We were sitting in a place called the West Bank, and it was Dominic, Gianese, myself, Tony Sirico, and Steve. The owner came up and said, take a walk down the corner. We didn't know. We took a walk down the corner. It was about 1 o'clock in the afternoon, and we saw it.
Oh, I love that. Yeah. It's a great story.
Stephen, you've obviously produced as well, so you've done quite a few things. What are the streams?
Well, I'm on Blue Bloods currently.
And I love it.
Yeah, I love it.
I've been on going into my fifth season. Mm-hmm. I've done some shows for Discovery. I've written 6 books. I've done a whole bunch of stuff. Sopranos was such a huge hit. It gave me opportunity to, do kind of a whole lot of stuff. And I had the New York Times bestseller. So happy to be here in Australia. We're doing 6 shows while we're here.
So how will this Q&A work? Is this the first time you've done something like
this? No, we've been doing this show in the States, a number of cities, in Miami, New York, and Detroit, and others. It's more than a Q&A. Like, there's a comedian who, gets everybody in a happy mood. They're going to show a bunch of clips, all our stuff, scenes from The Sopranos. Then we come out and we're interviewed first by a moderator. And it's a conversation with him, but between us and, talking about what it was like behind the scenes. Then we open it up for a Q&A to the audience. Okay. Now, that's where it gets unpredictable.
Then we do a meet and greet. So if you're a Soprano fan, any question you ever wanted to ask any of us, we give you a little peek behind the curtain and tell you what went on for 8 seasons, 7
seasons.
So
were you involved in writing any of the episodes?
Michael,
you were. So Christopher had a violent death, right? Big Pussy died from a gunshot wound to the chest.
No, 3 guys killed me.
Okay.
3 guys.
3 guys.
And Bobby was whacked by a couple of hitmen?
In a train store. I got killed in a... Bobby was into toy trains.
Okay.
I used to have a choo-choo hat, and then he went to buy a train, and he got killed in a train store.
Oh.
And the way you got killed, you kind of was a badge of honor. If they gave you a good send-off... all 3 got great send-offs, but you just faded away, that was kind of a little disrespectful,
So in terms of the writing, what made you really want to get involved in that? Just better endings for everyone?
No. After I shot the first season of the show, I just fell in love with it. Mm. And I had already done been writing some screenplays, so I just decided I was having so much fun, loved all the characters. I just wanted to be involved as much as I could.
And working with James, who we've sadly lost, what was the camaraderie like on set?
Yeah, he's our best friend.
He was such a good guy. As great an actor he was, he was a better guy. We had a lot of laughs with him. We traveled together over the years and hung around together. It was like going to work with your best friends, you know? I don't know about how it is on the soap.
It is best friends. We're like a family.
You get close, and we travel together, and vacations, and divorces, and kids. And
you go through a whole life with each other.
And that's how it was.
Yeah, it's true. And hopefully you all like each other. Otherwise, it would be a miserable job, right?
And this was a show where a once-in-a-lifetime we all got along great, you know?
That's amazing.
Did you all feel as if you ended up being typecast?
Well, I get typecast, but, you know, so is John Wayne.
I play a cop now.
Yeah,
so, and I've done other stuff. And listen, I'm not going to play an English professor. It is what it
not
is.
Yet. You know? It's always time.
And what are you both doing now?
I'm doing a show in New York called Wu-Tang Clan. It's a series.
Okay.
And I'm also teaching at down in HB Studio.
That's nice to be shooting in New York, right?
Yeah. I shoot in New York, yeah.
Tell me,
you're doing?
I have a new series premiere later this year called Lincoln in on NBC, and a movie called Primal with Nicolas Cage coming out later.
Oh, wow.
Now, what about the prequel that's coming up?
Well, it's set in the late 60s, and some of there'd be like early versions of some of the older characters, mm-hmm. but James Gandolfini's son Michael is playing the young Tony Soprano.
Yeah, they casted us as younger guys.
Yeah. Not me. Yeah. I wasn't, my character
but
wasn't
they got was playing your father.
My father, right. Yeah.
Wow, what a series, sensational.
Yeah.
Okay, with all the shows that you've done, and you're here in Australia for six, what's the most asked question from your fans?
Probably about the ending, mm-hmm. if Tony Soprano's alive or dead.
Right.
What did it mean, what happened, why did it go to black, and what all that means. Yeah.
Okay, well guys, congratulations. It's called In Conversation.
In Conversation
with the Sopranos.
In Conversation
six
with
cities.
The Sopranos, six cities. We're in Perth and Adelaide and Gold Coast and Sydney this Saturday.
There you go.
Tomorrow night.
There they are. There's all the stuff where we'll be.
Excellent.
Go to
abstractentertainment.net and come and have some fun with us.
Got a shrimp on the Barbie.
We've been eating Italian food. The Italian food's been great here.
We have very good Italian food.
Great. We went to a place, Cipri. It was great Italian
food. Yes, in Paddington.
We went around the harbour yesterday on a boat, and we saw everything.
Well, tomorrow night in Canberra. And then you head around, see all the details there. That's when you can get all. Gentlemen, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Pleasure.